we on?
Oh my god.
Welcome to Incredible Tiny. This is a carpenter's workout right there on sawhorses. I'm Randy Jones with Incredible Tiny Homes. We got a plumbing video for you. Come over here, look at this. All right, everybody. We did a plumbing the other day, and I was saying, this goes here, and that goes there, and this goes here, and this is a trap, and this. Now we got the real deal. I just got back from outer space. They've already sprayed on this, but let me show you what's going on. Hey, do we have the blueprints for this?
Right over there in my box.
Let me show you what we got. This is Brett and Logan. They're the ones building this house. All right, this is our blueprint, okay? As you can see, that's the tongues. We just lay this down right here. They have the toilet over here. The shower's right there, right? We have a sink. Can you see this? The sink right here. And then we've got a washer and dryer right there. We have a kitchen sink over there. Now the washer and dryer, what's got gas? The stove?
The range and the
yeah.
Water heater.
So we got a gas line right there for the stove, and the water heater will be in the tongue box. So, what we did, hey, let's hold off that drilling.
No,
yeah, come here, that's all right. No. I want Brett to tell you guys what he did. He plumbed this and we walked over, so. What did you do, and what was your challenges?
The drains in this trailer with all those beams.
Where did you start? Like, where did you start plumbing or thinking about stuff?
Right at the toilet. Work my way back.
Can you hear?
Yep.
So this is where all the big 3-inch lines were, and remember you and I were trying to sort it out that one.
Yep.
Thing.
Yep.
And basically just reverse engineered it. Went.
Get his probe. He's beautiful. You got to get on this side and stare right out. Hey, now, how did you know where that toilet goes? Like, how did you know where
so
to put that pipe?
We looked at the prints.
Okay, but, like, how come it wasn't an inch this way or an inch that way? Or why is it right there?
So, toilet's 12 and a half to the center of the drain from the wall, from the interior wall. So we had to figure we're going to have a 2x4 wall plus 3/4 of an inch. Then we get a core 12 and a half from that.
12 and a half to the center.
12 and a half
okay.
to the center.
So that's like a cornerstone where we start. So,
yeah.
All right.
Yep, and then so since this is, you can't really see, but all this plumbing down here is this side. It's all 3-inch.
So I know I was late. I was wanting to get here before he sprayed.
Yeah, I got pictures. We can show the pictures. Here, so.
Okay.
So I wanted to lay out all the big stuff first, make sure that was all fit. Because I had to put it all in this one cavity right here. So this thing kind of snakes around, and it has to tee up for the sink and the vent. Then we have to catch the kitchen sink and the washer come into there. And then,
okay, so like right here. Right here is the kitchen sink.
That's the kitchen. This is going to be the kitchen sink. This is at the far end of the drain. So the very top of the drain.
Gotcha.
So kitchen sink's going to be right about here. Drain in here.
Goes down there. This is going to be a wall. So the shower, 36-inch shower right here. This is going to be a wall that holds the shower up. Has the valve for the washer and dryer that's going to be right here.
Okay.
And also the valve for the shower.
Oh, the shower, that's an interior wall with all the plumbing too right there.
Yep, and then so this is going to be the drain and the vent. Well, the washing machine, because the washing machine has to have its own.
Okay, vent. You know, what's a vent? We'll tell you what a vent is.
Oh yeah, vent, you see on that house, way up at the top.
Way up there.
That's an air vent, so basically it takes all the nasty sewer gas smell out of your house, so. That's why your house at home doesn't smell terrible, because if you go outside and look on your roof, you call them roof jacks. You'll see these pipes, black or white pipes sticking up. And that's to exhaust all the sewer gas smell.
Right. Well, we don't like to go through the roof, because we're at 13.6, and we don't want to perforate the metal roofing as often as we can, so we go out the side. And then that one right there is
the shower. The shower's going to come 36 inches. Well, so the shower will be about here, right down the wall. And then there's the P-trap camera that we should have done earlier. P-trap there for the shower, also keep the nasty smell out. And then that all ties in to this 3-inch line that's buried under all this foam. And it goes right over here and goes straight down out the bottom of the.
It goes straight down. Show them that. Let's get under there. Show them
the trailer. You can see it down there.
Kind of hard to see with that jack in the way, but
awesome.
That's where the sewer, wherever this house winds up, I think it's going to Michigan.
Yes.
Pretty sure it's Michigan.
Yeah.
But that's where it'll connect to the sewer.
Unless the year you. That's perfect. All right, water lines.
Water lines. Okay, so those are probably over there. So in the front.
How do they work and what do they do?
Imagine it's going to have a box like that, but half the height, and there's going to be a window right there.
Okay.
Okay. Tight. You stuck with like a 3 foot box. On the outside wall of it, like that in there, by near this, will be the water heater. So the water line will come in. The blue line is cold. The red line is hot. So the water line will come in, go into the water heater. And then, if we follow these down, these go all the way down to hot and cold, right next to each other. Their first stop, they're coming out of the ground here. This is where the about where the kitchen sink's going to be. So they'll be up under the cabinet and we'll plumb it in there. Then it continues down here to this wall we're talking about, where the shower, it's going to separate the shower from the little laundry closet. And same thing, hot and cold are going to come up here, tee off, and then it keeps going, goes all the way down around to here. The last stop for the hot is, this is going to be a half moon, crescent moon sink. So that's the last stop for the hot, so it's going to go terminate there. Then this blue one goes down around here, you can kind of see it, down around here, pops up about 6 inches off center of the toilet for the water bottle.
Nice.
So I think it's six out from there.
Yeah,
somewhere around there.
6 inches center. And also, we put 3 inches of spray foam underneath all of the water lines. Okay, so it was 3 inches of spray foam, 100. And also the warm, when he puts plywood on here and this room gets warm, that water will stay warm because of the interior temperature of the house. Isn't that cool?
Yeah, I like the spray foam.
Now we're done.
Yep. So now we're just putting, we're just pouring this out so the subfloor can clear our plumbing.
Yeah,
and then in the next couple hours, probably after, we'll get the subfloor.
That
big, thick Advantech plywood over there.
Now, another thing that this does, the wood does, is that the spray foam's good in the floor, but this wood prevents bridging of cold temperatures going through that steel, right?
Okay, you're good. Yeah, that was for you. They already know all this stuff.
Yeah, we know that.
They already know all that stuff.
But they'll put the wood on here, when this gets cold, 40 below zero, it'll be harder for that cold air to bridge through that plywood and the subfloor to get to you guys. So this is a new concept that we've come up with, putting a little bit of wood on top of the steel, and also the plumbing in the floor and everything instead of the walls, so we can put more insulation in the floor. And then normally, if you're in a cold climate, you're going to skirt the outside perimeter of your house. All right. Here's Mike from Joycey.
Dirty Jars.
Everybody, thanks for tuning in. I'm Randy Jones from Incredible Tiny Homes.
And I'm Mike.
And that's Mike.
And that's Brett.
And that's Logan. We're about to go to lunch. Everybody, keep on your toes. Watch out for our videos. Listen to that rhyme. Keep on your toes. All right, everybody, thank you for tuning in. We're going to bring you more and more stuff every day. All right? IncredibleTinyHomes.com.